In this video, we are going to see about sublimation. What do you mean by sublimation? Certain solid substances change directly from solid to gaseous state without attaining liquid state. This is called sublimation. For example, camphor. What example? Camphor. So camphor means, you know, it is used in the Indian household for some good pleasant smell. Is it no? So when we ignite the camphor, camphor is a solid state. After igniting, it change into gases. It not attaining liquid state. So this is called sublimation process. Usually, the physical states are solid, liquid and gas. So solid change into liquid and liquid change into gases. Again, gas change into as a vapors of liquid or solid. Here, the solid directly attain the gaseous state. That's why this is called sublimation. So let's learn about sublimation by using an experiment. We are going to take ammonium powder and sand. The powder mixture of ammonium chloride and sand is taken in a china dish and cover this china dish by using an inverted funnel. The open end of the stem of the funnel is closed using cotton. Then the china dish is heated. The pure volatile substance called ammonium chloride change into vapors and condense in the walls of the funnel. Then the non-volatile impurities remain in the china dish. Now remove the funnel from the china dish and scrap the ammonium chloride to separately. Then the remaining of sand is in the china dish as a impurities. This is non-volatile. Non-volatile means aviyagadu, okay, not vaporize. The ammonium chloride is a volatile substance. Volatile substance means volatile solid, that is volatile means aviyagradu. Okay, the pure vapors of the volatile solid ammonium chloride is change solid to gas. But the impurities sand is remain in the china dish. So this is the process of sublimation. Thank you, my dears.